I have Sofya Gollan with me. And Sofya is a film writer, a film director, a playwright, and also an actor. Some of you may actually know Sofya from play school. So, Sofya, you've developed and are now writing a film called Gimpsey, which you're currently crowdfunding for. Could you tell me a little bit about the film? Well, yeah, I'm making a short film about a girl who has cerebral palsy, and she's about 17, 18, and she really lacks confidence. But she has a best friend who calls her Gimpsey, which she goes along with, or, you know, let's say she tolerates. But she really wants her friend to stop calling her Gimpsey, but she doesn't really know how to do that. You see, her best friend's really pretty and very popular, and so by association, she gets invited along to all the fun parties. But the film explores the moment of, you know, whether it's worth feeling a little dead on the inside every time she hears that name. You know, whether the friendship is really worthwhile. The friends become toxic, so it's really not worth pursuing the friendship, but she doesn't really know how to let go of the relationship. So she goes out one night and she meets a lovely boy who shows her, you know, just how to let go of her friend and shows her how to be a little bit more confident. And I know it might seem strange that I'm deaf and I'm making a film about a girl with a physical disability, but I think if you understand disability and some of the issues, you'll find that they're the same. Like being confident and assertive and, you know, what's right and what's wrong. There are similarities in being deaf. Oh, that's lovely. Lovely. I remember your film from about 15 years ago from the Bondi Film Festival. Flickerfest. The film was titled Chlorine Dreams, about a girl who had a relationship with a ghost underwater. It was a very powerful film, but back then we didn't really talk much about mental health or disability. I think it was kind of hush-hush. I mean, now we're much more open, much more revealing, and now you yourself as a deaf film writer and director, have you come up against any barriers? And, you know, if you compared your two films, what might those barriers be? Well, I didn't think the film Chlorine Dreams had anything to do with disability. I thought it was just a story about a girl who had an imaginary friend in her swimming pool. But a friend of mine said to me, oh, of course you'd make a film like this because, you know, nobody can hear underwater. And I thought, you know what, you're right. But you can't really escape from the essence of who you are or what you've experienced. And the life you lived will always come out in your storytelling. Now, I think these days it's much more acceptable to talk about disabilities and other issues. You know, I think now, you know, you can say, look, this is not right. We need to be more included. But, you know, we need more activism. Yeah, activism to be included into the workplace. And what I found, which I didn't think would happen, and perhaps I'm a little naive, I thought I could establish myself to have a good career in the film industry and that being deaf wouldn't matter. But I've actually found that I've faced many barriers. Because you're deaf and a woman? Well, both. So there are two layers of complexity to becoming an artist. The industry is very much about the white male. Well, the white young man. You know, their career tends to ascend rather quickly, but a woman has to think about when she's going to have children and then step out of the industry to have children. And I think if you have a disability, then people are unsure if you can be, you know, in charge of a multi-million dollar production and be successful. Oh, you can. Well, I can, and I have. But you know, you have to convince people, the gatekeepers, to let you through the gate. Yeah. So I think, you know, most people are quite open. Well, thank you. Thank you, Sofya. I really appreciate your time. I'm looking forward to seeing Gimpsey coming out soon. Look, it would be wonderful if you could help support the film, because we are currently raising funds, and even a small contribution would be wonderful, because it all then adds up towards helping us to make the film. Thank you. I'm really looking forward to it. Thank you, Sofya. Thank you.